In the waters of baptism, Mary died with Christ to rise with him to new life. May Mary now share eternal life with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I invite you to stand. So we gather this morning in sadness as we gather for this Requiem service for the happy repose of the soul of Mary McComish. And I want to, on behalf of the parish community, extend sincere sympathy to Mary's immediate family. First of all, to her sons and daughters, to Paul, Patricia, Gabriel, Liam, Connor, Claire, and Jared. To you, her 21 grandchildren. To you, her 2 great-grandchildren. And I extend that sympathy to members of the family who are not able to be with us here, who are watching online, and I'm aware, for example, there's some watching from Australia. So we think about you, and we hold you in our prayer at this time. I extend that sympathy to the wider family circle who are present with us here in church. And remembering and commending into God's loving mercy deceased members of Mary's family, her parents Patrick and Mary, her late husband Billy, brother Gabriel, daughter Nuala. So you're very welcome if you're from this parish or other parishes. A welcome also to anyone who may be from another Christian denomination or another religion or no religion. We're going to pause for a few moments now. And after a moment or two of silence, I'm going to begin with the opening prayer. Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life, so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant, Mary, to be inscribed in the book of life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. I invite you now to be seated. We come now to the Liturgy of the Word, and I invite Claire to bring us the first reading. Olive will sing the psalm, and then I'll read the gospel passage. So we'll listen now for God's word.
A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. I, John, heard a voice from heaven say to me, "Write down, happy are those who die in the Lord. Happy indeed," the Spirit says, "now they can rest forever after their work, since their good deeds go with them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "In your prayers, do not babble as the pagans do, for they think that by using many words, they'll make themselves heard. Do not be like them. Your Father knows what you need before you ask him, so you should pray like this. Our Father in heaven, may your name be held holy. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we have forgiven those who are in debt to us. Do not put us to the test, but save us from the evil one. Yes, if you forgive others their failings, your heavenly Father will forgive you yours. But if you do not forgive others, your Father will not forgive your failings either. The Gospel of the Lord. And if you'd like to be seated. I thought for Mary's funeral that I would choose this gospel passage. It's a gospel passage that is used for the Tuesday of the first week of Lent. In the course of her 91 years, Mary would have prayed that prayer that we know as the Our Father or the Lord's Prayer, depending on your Christian tradition, countless times. And for someone who had her rosary beads with her when she went to bed at night, this was one of the prayers that was part of the rosary. I suppose in many ways, the Our Father had become almost part of Mary's life. And she would have prayed that prayer many times for many different people, but especially for you, her family. And as I mentioned family, we think today especially of you. That even though a loved one, as Mary has lived a long life, when that moment of parting actually comes, it's still painful. And so we hold you in our prayer that you will have all the support and comfort you need, especially during the difficult times. In this Requiem service, we follow Catholic tradition of praying for the dead, praying that God will be merciful to Mary, forgiving her any of her earthly faults and failings, and bring her to the happiness and the light of heaven. And that theme of mercy is central to this prayer. At the time of a funeral, I like to reflect on the life of the person who has died, and in doing so, providing us an opportunity to take stock of our own lives. And with the busyness of life, we don't often get a chance to do that. The funeral is one of those times whenever we slow things down a bit and take time to listen. Mary was born on the 5th of February 1933, growing up in the Beachmont area of the city, just a little bit further down from us here. When still a baby, her only brother Gabriel died. So as a child, it really meant she was growing up as an only child. Early in her childhood, Mary's mother also died, and she was then brought up by her father and stepmother. And then a few years into her childhood, the Second World War broke out. And for some time, Belfast, of course, was under threat in what we know as the Blitz of 1941. And like so many other children here in the city at that time, she was evacuated, in her case, for a short time, to White Abbey. As a child, Mary was sporty, particularly playing camogie. She was also, growing up as a young person, a member of the Legion of Mary. Her faith was very strong and important to her. After leaving school, she trained in secretarial skills with a little dressmaking as well. But her work really was you, her family. Mary married her husband Billy on the 12th of October 1959 in St. Paul's Church, just further down the Falls Road opposite the Royal. And she was blessed with a wonderful marriage and life together as a couple. And as a couple, they in turn were blessed with 8 children, 21 grandchildren, and 2 great-grandchildren, and as the family say, and counting. Sadly, Billy died on the 22nd of May 2009. In thinking about the influence of Mary and Billy, they loved, guided, and encouraged their family in their individual interests, hopes, and dreams. And maybe in thinking again of those in Australia, that could be part of that encouragement. I was very struck by a phrase that Mary's family used in the briefing notes that I have here, when it talks about her as she loved to nourish and nurture her family and encouraging that sense of adventure and travel and seeing the world. Wanting her family to experience different cultures and broaden their horizons. And how important is that for us here in this small island, in this small part of the world? And go back to that idea of nourishing and nurturing, the importance of food and family meals. She loved to cook for her entire family and any of her friends who stepped in through the back kitchen door. And my experience of the week is, I have to say, very much one of hospitality and been offered food. So that sense of what was really important for Mary seems to have passed down the family. And how important is that hospitality nowadays, the importance of food? To hold for you as her family the happy memories of the little kitchen and the many conversations, the wise advice, maybe at times the scolding as well, and some of the sweet treats. She had the ability, and what a skill this is, with a sense of humor, to be direct and diplomatic, and yet at the same time, diplomatic, with a strong moral compass, and certainly something for all of us to reflect on that. For you as her family to give God thanks for the fact that she was blessed with great intelligence, what you describe as a repressed journalist, someone who was fascinated by local and international news, and again, a real value in looking beyond this small island here. And maybe it could be as the years go on that some of the family, in looking back, will really appreciate how she taped TV news stories on her VHS video recorder in the 80s and 90s. Might have been appreciated at the time, but whenever looking back, for anybody involved in research or archives, those things can be really gold dust. Mary's long life has now come to an end. But we're people of hope. We believe in life beyond the grave. And we believe that as Jesus was brought back to life again after his death, that our hope is that Mary will be given eternal life in the kingdom of heaven as we commend her now once more into God's loving mercy. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. I invite you to stand. And today, Connor, Beth, Kerry, and Orla lead the prayer of the faithful. God, the Almighty Father, raised Jesus, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
In baptism, Mary received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Our sister Mary was nourished at the table of the Saviour. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. And we pray also for others who have died recently, for Phyllis Drain, Father Sean Moore, Patrick McCafferty Sr. Lord, hear us. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers that we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord. And I invite you now to be seated. And I invite you to stand. And now we pray that prayer which Jesus taught his disciples to pray, a prayer that Mary prayed many times. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us offer one another some sign of Christ's peace. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Mary may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. And we ask this now through Christ our Lord. And I invite you to remain standing for the final prayer and commendation. Let us pray. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express affection for her. May it ease sadness. May it strengthen hope. The hope of one day joyfully greeting her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We're not going to move into another time of silence. And this time during the silence, I'm going to sprinkle Mary's coffin with holy water, reminding us of her baptism. And the white pall that covers her coffin here is another reminder of her baptism. When we're baptized, we're clothed in a white garment. This white garment symbolizes the end of the baptismal journey. And then out of respect for her body, I'm going to incense her coffin. And then I invite you, as you see the smoke rise from the thurible, to see this as a symbol of prayer rising to God. We pray in silence. And the response is, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we now commend our sister Mary, in the hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for all the blessings which you bestowed upon Mary in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards Mary's family and listen to their prayer. Open the gates of paradise to Mary and help all of us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and to be with our sister forever. We ask this now through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
You.